بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. الحمد لله رب العالمين، وصلى الله وسلم وبارك على سيدنا محمد سيد الأولين والآخرين وحبيب رب العالمين، وعلى آله الطيبين الطاهرين، ورضي الله عن أصحابه أجمعين، وعنا معهم برحمتك يا أرحم الراحمين. العلماء والعظام، حاضرين الكرام، السلام عليكم ورحمة الله تعالى وبركاته. Let's start with the Quran. The best thing that we can start with is the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. As always, do you find anything better than the book of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to start with? بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ الْحِكْمَةِ. I'm telling you this, and I know all of you already know this, that the meaning of the ayah here, وَلَقَدْ آتَيْنَا لُقْمَانَ الْحِكْمَةِ, we have given Luqman the hikmah, the wisdom. But every word in the Quran has hikmah. And Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave Luqman alayhi salam al-hikmah, hence we call him Luqman al-Hakim. And then in another ayah Allah says, وَمَنْ يُؤْتَ الْحِكْمَةَ فَقَدْ أُوْتِيَ خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. Not only khayr. And Allah says, whoever is given the hikmah, who gives the hikmah? Allah. So whoever Allah gives the hikmah to, Allah mentions فَقَدْ أُوْتِيَ خَيْرًا, he has been given a khayr. But not only khayr, لا, خَيْرًا كَثِيرًا. لأن only those people who have hikmah understand, and only those who have hikmah appreciate. Well, you all know this, this is common sense. If people have no hikmah, do they have appreciation? SubhanAllah. لكن who has appreciation? Those whom Allah given hikmah. Therefore, look in your heart. When you see hikmah, then you know Allah will for you good. Therefore, they stopped Luqman Hakim. They stopped him one time. They say, because Luqman, the narrations say that Luqman from East Africa, yani from Africa, dark person in color, yani skin pigmentation is dark. And you know, lips and the features of Africans, so people were making fun of him, and they say they were calling him, you the oh dark man. He told them, if you look at my skin and you see my skin is dark, but my heart is pure for Allah.
Subhanallah.
So we don't judge people by what they don't they hear in this country. They also say looks may be deceiving. Ajib. لكن القرآن الكريم والنبي الأعظم صلى الله عليه وآله وسلم. And I would like to beg you, every time you hear the name of someone that you love very much, and we all love very much, please do not be stingy, but make your salah and salam known on al-habib al-a'zam صلى الله عليه وسلم. Because at least you can remind one next to you, or you remind me, or maybe remind others that are not present, or maybe they remind you. Yeah. لكن النبي الأعظم صلى الله عليه وسلم في الصحيح mentioned إن الله لا ينظر إلى صوركم ولا إلى أجسادكم. Allah does not look at your frames. Allah does not look at your structure, your body physique. ولكن ينظر إلى قلوبكم. التقوى ها هنا. التقوى is right here. عجيب. Therefore, the iman of the awliya radiyallahu ta'ala anhum, if you were to measure the iman of the awliya with the mountains, the iman of the awliya would overweigh the mountains.
Subhanallah.
يعني بلال الحبشي, tell me he's not wise. شوف حكمة, look at the حكمة في سيدنا بلال بن رباح الحبشي. هذا, he used to be enslaved, هو free, he's, by the way, he's always been free. حتى when they enslaved him, he was free. لأن his mind was free. His تفكير, his فكر was free. His heart was free. Even if they put chains, do you think those people, many of the people who they put in chains, remember Abu Hanifa, didn't they put him in jail? والإمام الشافعي was in jail وأحمد بن حنبل was in jail. They put many of the أولياء in jail, but they might chain their bodies, but their روح is free for Allah رب العالمين.
سبحان الله.
Who can jail? Can you jail the روح? Can anyone put the jail for the soul? لا. يسألونك عن الروح. القرآن mentions. They ask you about the روح. Who has control of the روح? قل الروح من أمر ربي. You can jail the body, لكن you can never control the روح. Therefore سيدنا بلال رضي الله تعالى عليه, when they put him on this, on the desert and it's burning and all this, what was his answer? حكمة. أحد أحد. فرد صمد. لا والد ولا ولد.
سبحان الله.
ومن يؤتى الحكمة. We're talking, I'm bringing some examples because we're talking about حكمة. And حكمة, in the old days, they didn't call the doctor or physician. In the old days, they used to go, even open up in the old days, they would call the one who treats the bodies, يعني now we call him medical doctor, they would call him حكيم or a man of wisdom. Huh? Yes or no?
Yes.
Of course. They would call him a man of wisdom. Why? Because he is able to treat the disease of the bodies. Look at this. Now let me ask you by Allah Jalla Jalaluhu, the Almighty, who is more important, the one who treats the bodies from disease or the one who treats the hearts from disease? The one who may save your life if you are sick so now you can live a comfortable life, or the one who saves you in the dunya and in the akhirah? Muhammadun Rasulullah. It's not a matter of giving you simply a dosage, disease, the medication so you can live your life happy. لا, he gives you النبي الأعظم صلى الله عليه وسلم from the pharmacy of محمد رسول الله صلى الله عليه وسلم. He gives you medication where you can live in the dunya and in the akhirah and in the qabr disease free and happy.
SubhanAllah.
And that's the beauty of المصطفى صلى الله عليه وسلم. People can claim to be people of medicine. لكن the real medicine is the prophetic medicine. لأن النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم, and I'm saying physical, not only spiritual. Spiritual for sure, لكن also physical. Because Allah is the one who created the human beings. And Allah is the one who created the son of Adam. And Allah is the one who put all these organs in the son of Adam. And Allah sent his messenger and gave him the knowledge of all these things to treat people and guide people to the way of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. So he has to know. Otherwise, it would lead to jahl. And hasha Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, ma'adallah, that the Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam is ignorant in that. So they used to come to him. Ya Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. The woman that came to him, he said, Rasulullah, I have disease, I fall, I lose consciousness. All these things you all know. Let's go to the definition of shukr, because thankfulness and wisdom are coupled. Why? Why are they synonymous? If you have wisdom, you will be shakur, shakir. You will be thankful. If you have no wisdom, you will not be shakir. Why? وَلَقَدْ أَعْتَنَا لُكْمَانَ الْحِكْمَةِ أَنِشْكُرْ لِلَّهِ. Look at the whole ayah tells you. Allah says, which means we have given لُكْمَانَ الْحِكْمَةِ. نعم يا. Why? أَنِشْكُرْ لِلَّهِ. Make shukr to Allah. The reason for the hikmah that you make shukr. What's the definition of shukr or thankfulness? Many people have different opinions on the definition, and the problem is not in the definition only, the problem in the practice. They say the definition is al-i'tiraf wal-qiyam bil-khidma, that you admit to the one who has given you a favor and you serve them. That some others say different. And that's where we have to check ourselves. Are we really thanking Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? يعني when you say alhamdulillah, is this what you're supposed to do? Or what is the point? Where is the shukr? That a shukr turns out to be different. Number one, al-mahabbatu fil-qalb. The first thing, The first sign of you being thankful to Allah that you have the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your heart by admitting His endowments and ni'mas on you in your heart before you speak. You know what? The point is not saying alhamdulillah like this. La. لأن الشاعر says إنما الكلام على في الفؤاد وإنما جعل اللسان على الفؤاد دليلا. The speech, the kalam is in the heart. Like the poet says, the tongue simply translates what the heart speaks. Notice, if your heart does not say alhamdulillah, then no matter how much your lips say alhamdulillah, it doesn't make any difference. That means there is a difference between your inner and outer. What you mean in your heart, you do not say, and that's the problem. Many people restrict alhamdulillah to words they say. When it's supposed to be, where does it originate? In the heart. And if originate, notice this, if the sugar and the thankfulness originates in the heart, where does it go? To the limbs. عمل بالأركان. Now your heart will have the belief in Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala and the thankfulness and the confession, and that will reflect on your limbs, and your limbs will be in obedience of Allah. That's the second stage of shukr as well. First stage in the heart. Second is in the limbs. The third stage is in the mouth. وَجَرَيَانُ اللِّسَانِ بِذِكْرِهِ وَالثَّنَاءِ عَلَيْهِ. Your tongue doesn't only mention him. لا. جَرَيَان, it means it runs. Your tongue runs with the thanking of Allah and the praising of Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. That's the three important things. Often people, what do? They only utter it with their tongue, not running on their tongue, uttering with their tongue. You see the problem? Some people say, anyone, why do we have to be so thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala? بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم وَإِن تَعُدُّوا نِعْمَةَ اللَّهِ لَا تُحْصُوهَا. The ayah means, if you were to count the ni'mas, the favors Allah has given you, you can never encounter them. You can never count them. They are countless. Al-ulama, they say, let's divide the ni'mah into three categories, al-ni'mas. First, what kind of ni'mah? Ni'mah dunyawiya. Dunyawi ni'mah. Allah gives you dunyawi favors. What does that mean? He gives you health. He gives you good thinking. He gives you good family. He gives you good things in the dunya. La, he gives you money, halal. Notice I'm saying halal money. Why am I saying halal money? Because haram money is not ni'mah. Haram money is punishment. Haram money is jahannam. But halal money is ni'mah. Na'am. Na'am. Halal money is ni'mah, of course. Malan halala, of course. May Allah give us all halal money. Amen. But if he gives you haram money, you have to be, what do you have to do? That's not ni'mah in a sense, that's something that will take you deep down to Jahannam. وَالْعِيَادُ بِاللَّهِ وَبِئْسَ الْمَصِيرُ. That could be if he gives you ni'mah. No, some people think that it's the point is to have higher number of money. Now, halal, haram, whatever it is, let's bring it all together as long as you have that. Wallahi, it doesn't work. You think we can fool Allah Rabbul Alameen? The poet says, جَمَعَ الْحَلَالِ عَلَى الْحَرَامِ لِيُكْثِرَ دَخَلَ الْحَرَامُ فِي الْحَلَالِ فَبَعْثَرَ. He put the haram with the halal to make it kathir, to increase it. But when the haram entered with the halal, بَعْثَرَ, it destroyed it. The haram destroys the haram and the halal with it. Not only it destroys the haram, it destroys the haram and the halal. It's نَارُ اللَّهِ الْمُقَدَى. لا. Other kinds of ni'mah, favors. Favors, for example, diniya. Ni'am diniya. For example, Allah gives you, facilitate for you to do good deeds. Amal salih. When you come to the masjid, هذه نعمة. This is a great ni'mah that Allah enabled you today to come to the masjid. There is ni'mah, there is lutuf from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. There is care from Allah to facilitate for you to make it to his home, to his house, to sit and listen to his dhikr, Jalla Jalala. Ni'mah. Allah, he gives you ilm, become alim. Ni'mah, azeema, ni'am. This is ni'mah. Can you count them? Allah, he gives you other things that makes your deen ikhlas. He gives you ihsan. All these things are ni'am dun diniya. He may give you different kind of ni'mah. It's called ni'am ukhrawiya fil akhirah. What do you mean fil akhirah? As in the akhirah? The akhirah is supposed to be either you go to this or you go to that. Huh? Lakin they say no. He gives al-mu'mineen favors also fil akhirah. How come? He says, the ulama said, that you do something very small in the dunya, Allah rewards you fil akhirah there abundantly for it. Little thing you do. You think this is insignificant. Yeah, one time you stopped by a faqir and you gave him a pound. You thought, hey, what is a pound? Yeah, the Iceman, huh? Lakin you don't know that this faqir could make a dua for you in the middle of the night. Oh Allah, forgive this person for he helped my need. And because this, Allah may forgive your whole sins and let you enter Jannah. So he gives his slaves fil akhirah, those who he likes, Jalla Jalaluh, massive rewards for little things. Isn't this a big ni'mah? You know why? لأن الله كريم. He is كريم سبحانه وتعالى. And when you deal with the كريم, there are no counts. Huh? When you deal with people, with human beings, you always have to be exact. Now there are people who are called accountants. Huh? That's their specialty. Because they have to make sure all the accounts. لكن with Allah رب العالمين, no, guess what? Forget the accountants. يرزق من يشاء بغير حساب. He gives whomever he wants and no need for accountants. إنما يوفى الصابرون أجرهم بغير حساب. You could be صابر, Allah will give you your reward without any. بغير حساب. You are dealing with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore try, when you deal with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, act this way. Let's go on a little bit. What is the biggest ni'mah Allah gave us? What is the biggest ni'mah that Allah gave you? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Al-Yawma akmaltu lakum dinakum wa atmamtu alaykum ni'mati. I have completed my ni'mah in you by what, ya Allah? Wa radhitu lakum al-Islam deena. And I have perfected the ni'mah, I have completed my favor on you and made you Muslims. This ni'mah, you have the love of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala in your heart. This is not easy. This is a big ni'mah, khususiyya, that you have the love of Rasulullah sallallahu alayhi wa sallam in your heart. It's not meant to be for everybody, ajeeb. وهو النبي الأعظم صلى الله عليه وسلم والرسول الأفخم والنور المجسم والكنز المطلسم صلى الله عليه وآله وهو خير خلق الله سيد الأنبياء والمرسلين. لكن still some people don't see the nur. Is the problem? Now let me ask you this. If some people don't see the sun shining, is the problem with the sun or the problem with their eyes? Where is the problem? The sun is shining, he says, I don't see the sun. Now check your heart. Check your heart first. If your heart functions, then and your eyes function, then you can see the sun. If your eyes don't function, then... قَدْ تُنْكِرُ الْعَيْنُ
الْمُصِيرِ رَحْمَةُ اللَّهِ عَلَيْهِ. Imam Musiri, صاحب البردة.
What does he say? قَدْ تُنْكِرُ الْعَيْنُ ضَوْءَ الشَّمْسِ مِنْ رَمَدٍ وَيُنْكِرُ الْفَمُ طَعْمَ الْمَاءِ مِنْ سَقَمِ. The eye may deny the light of the sun because the eye is diseased. And the mouth may deny the sweet taste of the water, not because the water is not sweet, but because the mouth is diseased. So those people who don't feel the love for Nabi al-A'zam, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, check your hearts, there's a problem. The biggest ni'mah is the ni'mah that Allah gave us, Islam. The ni'mah. And the reason I told you this because Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala has حَبَّبَ إِلَيْكُمُ الْإِيمَانِ. He says in the Quran Kareem, حبب إليكم الإيمان. He made إيمان beloved to you. وزينه في قلوبكم. And he beautified إيمان in your hearts. Look at this.
هذا القرآن الكريم says this.
He made إيمان beloved to you and he beautified it in your hearts.
سبحان الله. You see the نعمة؟ طيب. More.
The نعمة is also this ni'mah that Allah gave us requires shukr, requires thanking. Lots of thanking. Now we thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, number one, of course. We say alhamdulillah, our limbs also practice the thanking of Allah by not disobeying Him. Our heart practice the thanking of Allah by always being in observance of Him and muraqabah of Him subhanahu wa ta'ala. This is how the shukr is. Yes. But they say that's not enough. What else you have to do? They say you have to also thank the creation whom Allah facilitate to guide you or to give you the ni'mah.
What does that mean? You have to give shukr to the creation? Na'am. Na'am.
Why? And let me ask you this. Where would have we would have been without an-Nabiyul A'zam sallallahu alayhi wa sallam? He is makhluq sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. He is not khaliq.
He is makhluq.
He is created. He is the best creation of Allah. But he is creation sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. And Allah gave us the good and the khair and the guidance and the love and all the good things through him sallallahu alayhi wa sallam. So it is only mandatory that we are thankful not only to Allah but to his prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.
You have to, and Abu Dawood ibn Majah narrates this hadith. The hadith is known, من لا يشكر الناس لا يشكر الله. أو لا يشكر الله من لا يشكر الناس حديث.
You are not thankful to Allah if you are not thankful to the people. What does that mean? It means two things. You are not thankful to Allah if you are not thankful to people. Those who do you favors.
الخطاب رحمه الله he says في المعالم
in his book he says if you are not thankful, the meaning of the hadith is if you are not thankful to people, then by definition, you are not thankful to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. يعني those who are not thankful to the النبي الأعظم صلى الله عليه وسلم, not thankful to the ulama and to the awliya and to the guide, and not thankful to those, to their parents,
to their parents.
Not thankful to those who did them favors, they are not thankful to Allah.
أشكر لي و
لوالديك إلي المصير. The Quran says you should be thankful to me. Allah says, which means you should أشكر لي. You should be thankful to me, only to me.
لا والمخلوق ولوالدي.
And you should be thankful to your parents. The creation or the creator. Which one can you thank in a sense easily? And which one can you fulfill the thanks easier?
To someone who did you a favor, or to Allah جل جلاله who did you countless favors. They say it's easy, of course, if someone did you one favor from the creation, you can easily thank them.
But Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, you have to worship your life. And you're not even thankful, you're not enough. وَقَلِيلٌ مِّنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورُ Allah says, only few of my slaves are really thankful. Huh? They say since thanking the makhluq is easier, in a sense that you can just do it right away, those who do not thank, are not thankful to the creation, to an-nas, are not thankful to Allah. They don't even do the easy thing. Do you expect them to do the real thing? They don't even do the word thing and the little gesture. Do you expect them to stay up the night and do the hajjat?
It doesn't work.
Therefore, they say a shukr has three classifications. And the first classification is shukran bil lisan. You make thanks to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala with your tongue.
Ya salam.
What does that mean? Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim. Wa amma bi ni'mati rabbika fahaddith. Which means, the ayah means, by the ni'mas of your Lord, you should talk. To tell people about the ni'mah of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Therefore they say, if Allah has given you a ni'mah, admitting it is thanking it, thanking Allah for it. What does that mean? يعني you ask someone, he's doing okay, alhamdulillah.
Practical example. Business is okay, life is okay.
How are you doing? Oh,
very difficult. فالله سبحانه وتعالى made things easy for you.
Say alhamdulillah. Don't say very difficult, very this. No, I'm not happy. No. How are you doing? Alhamdulillah.
Subhanallah.
The first thing that comes out of your mouth when people ask you, because if Allah gives you ni'mah, and we are showered by the ni'mah of Allah, and when someone asks you, how are you doing, and you complain, then you're complaining about Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Say alhamdulillah. Stop giving the list of complaints. وَأَمَّا بِنِعْمَةِ رَبِّكَ فَحَدِّثْ. لذلك النبي صلى الله عليه وسلم على ذكر الحديث. الحديث الترمذي والنسائي أيضا and others narrate this hadith. والحديث عن النبي الأعظم صلى الله عليه وسلم he said عرض علي I was given the opportunity that the Mecca will turn ذهب will turn gold.
Allah gave me the opportunity.
If you want, we will turn Mecca into gold. You take the gold and whatever. Huh? And Nabi sallallahu alayhi wa sallam says, قَالَ قُلْتُ لَا يَا رَبْ. I says, no, oh Allah. For this way I will eat one day and I will be hungry the next day. I eat one day and I am hungry the next day. When I am hungry, then I will ask you and I will beg you ذَكَرْتُكَ and I begged you to give me. This way I remember you and I know you and I remember to thank you and then when I eat and I am full شَكَرْتُكَ وَحَمَدْتُكَ I will thank you and I will praise you. Look at Nabi al-A'zam وَهُوَ خَيْرُ خَلْقِ اللَّهِ. He wants to starve one day and eat one day. Why? So he in both cases what? He makes praise and shukr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. It's an opportunity to make shukr of Allah jalla jalaluhu. You all know the hadith also. The hadith is known where one of the people who are making سَمِعَ اللَّهُ لِمَنْ حَمِدَ قَالْ رَبَّنَا لَكَ الْحَمْدُ وَالشُّكْرِ كَمَا يَنْبَغِي لِجَلَالِ وَجْهِكَ وَلِعَظِيمِ سُلْطَانِكَ. Glory may be to you, Allah, that is suitable to the glorious sultan that you have. The hadith says that the malaika translate what you do into rewards. How much reward should we write for this? Malaika are asking each other, they're troubled. They ask Allah, they said, Ya Allah, this abd of yours, this slave of yours, he said this, we were confused. How should we translate this kind of thana, this kind of shukr, how should we translate it into rewards in our books? Allah tells us hadith, leave right his this as is, because I can only reward them for what he said. That's the first kind of shukr we're going to run through real quick. The second kind of shukr is with your deeds. With the amal. Why you say there's shukr with the amal? Now, of course. Allah, when he talks about Al Dawood, wa amalu Al Dawood, shukra. There's shukr. Your amal becomes shukr. When you make amal, when you do deeds, it's shukr. You know the hadith from Bukhari Muslim عن عائشة رضي الله عليها أم المؤمنين. السيدة عائشة looks at النبي الأعظم صلى الله عليه وسلم and he's doing قيام at night حتى تنفصل قدماها صلى الله عليه وآله until his feet are swollen at night at the night. She says يا رسول الله why do you do your, with yourself like this? وَقَدْ غُفِرَ لَكَ مَا تَقَدَّمَ مِنْ ذَنْبِكَ وَمَا تَأْخَرَ. And you are pure, you are everything. There's nothing for you. Why are you doing this? Why are you struggling? You know what he replied to her? Doing deeds? قَالَ يَا عَيْشَةَ. He told يَا عَيْشَةَ, shouldn't I be a thankful slave? أَفَلَا أَكُونُ عَبْدًا شَكُورًا. Shouldn't I be thankful? Look at the maqam of shukr. There is the higher maqam of shukr, which by Nabi al-Azam also fulfilled, is shukr in the heart. How do you thank Allah in your heart for the ni'mas He gave you? You don't see the ni'mas. You don't see the favors. How do you thank Him for the favor? You don't see the favor. You only see Allah. You don't see the one who gives you the favor. You don't see the favor, but you see the one who gives you the favor. You are not buried and barred by the, you have the favor becomes hijab. That favor does not make you overwhelmed, but what makes you overwhelmed is Allah who gave you the favor.
SubhanAllah.
So you are not mashghul bin ni'mati anil mun'im. By the ni'mah from the mun'im. Let me finish by saying a couple of things. There is the thankfulness of the awam. What Abu Dawud makes thankfulness, they shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They make shukr to Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala whenever something good comes to them. Yani, student passed in the university. Alhamdulillah, extra prayer, mashallah. La'ib, somebody buys a car. Very nice. Whenever something good happens to them, they make shukr to Allah. This is the shukr of the awam. I'm not talking about those who do not make shukr to Allah. At all. Be careful. What does that mean? بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم. والله أخرجكم من بطون أمهاتكم لا تعلمون شيئا وجعل لكم السمع والأبصار والأفئدة. Why? لعلكم تشكرون. Allah took you from the wombs of your mother. Then He gave you a سمع. He gave you the hearing, the ears, والأبصار and the eyes and the hearts. Why? لعلكم تشكرون. So you make sugar. So for those people who are absent, ghafil and shukr, just imagine, find someone who's blind. Go find someone who's blind. Stand next to him and close your eyes. And imagine if you will never gain your sight back. Then thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Open your eyes and thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. The second thing, real quick, is the shukr of al-fawas. What is the shukr of fawas? Is they thank Allah for when they have a good thing and when they have a bad thing happening to them. When they have a disaster, they thank Allah. And when they have an ease, they also thank Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. They thank Allah both ways, either ways, it doesn't make any difference. They're always with Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. For they know whatever comes to them is from Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, and whatever happens to them is good because that's what Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala wants. The five conditions, which I promise I will end with, for the real thankfulness, you have to have five conditions. Number one, al-khushu'u lil-mun'im. That you are, when you are thanking Allah, you are khashi' to Him. When you say alhamdulillah, you have khushu'. Number two, mahabbatul mun'im. That you have love for Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number three, dhikrul mun'im. That you make dhikr of Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Number four, praising the mun'im. That you praise Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. And number five, and the last condition is that you do not disobey Him with the favors He gave you. That you do not disobey Him with what He gave you basar, don't disobey Him with that basar. He gave you hearing, don't disobey Him with that hearing. These are the five conditions of thankfulness. If you do them, then you have thanked. If you have not, then there's a problem. I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala, as the time has come, I ask Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala to make us and you among the shakirin. You know why? Because Allah says, وَقَلِيلٌ مِنْ عِبَادِيَ الشَّكُورِ. Only few of my slaves are thankful to me. Oh Allah, make us among those who are qaleel. Because those qaleel Allah loves. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make us among those who are few. وَصَلَّى اللَّهُ وَسَلَّمَ وَبَارَكَ عَلَى سَيِّدْنَا مُحَمَّدٍ وَآلِهِ.